That's it. I'm already gone. I might need that.
Another triumph for Meridian.
Don't ask me where to go if you're lost. I'm a guard, not the town crier.
This must be the Shrine of Kings that Nalan told me about.
You won't get in there. That dried-up old prune in a robe sees to that.
I can be persuasive. But what does an Oseram want with a Karja shrine, anyway?
It reminds me of someone. Gone 2 years now. But what does a girl like you know of loss?
Try me.
I had a lover. Worked on monuments to their bastard king. Then he gave them a show in their sun ring for good measure. The Karja gave me back his broken bones, but what use are they? They won't build again. They won't make me smile.
And seeing a statue of the mad sun king will?
I need to see his work again. The marks his hands carved. The set of the metals they hammered. That's the soul of him. But that shriveled up old priest won't let me near it.
I'll see what I can do.
Turn away, child. The abiding Jahaman wishes to be alone in his retreat.
If you want to be alone, go someplace else. Others want to pray here.
Defile it, you mean? Yet another debasement of what was once pure. Truly, our tribe has lost the light. Our king is false, our temple is corrupt, and our soldiers weak. The sun hastens across the sky for shame.
I thought Avad taking the throne was the sun's will.
The boy dishonored his father. Dishonored us all. To kill a sun king. What shadow, what twilight time he brought upon us.
And how many more would the mad Sun King have killed if Avad hadn't stopped him?
The Sun called for blood. There was no choice but to obey.
So the Karja have become impure? What does that even mean?
Is Meridian not meant for those who built it, who made it great? It was pure before Outlander squatters took it over.
You mean Meridian was pure when the Outsiders were in cages or dying in your arena?
The sun is pure, child. It is not our place to question its divine will, only to act upon it.
You called the temple corrupt, but aren't you one of its priests?
They call themselves sun priests, but they have no authority. Youths and sycophants all. Yet those who gave their whole lives to the sun's service are shamed and ignored.
So that's what this is. A tantrum? A cry for attention?
You know nothing of our rights, and yet you dare to insult me!
Why do you think your army is weak? Because you're not at war with everyone?
A Karja throne relying on forged dirt mercenaries? Preposterous! The so-called liberation was nothing but a purge. Our most blessed warriors, chased out of the city, exiled to Sunfall and the Forbidden West. Our tribe is torn. The ones who walked in light now go by shadow.
And yet everyone but you seems happy they're gone. I'm done arguing with you. Stay or go, but I won't allow you to keep others away.
I am here by the will of the sun.
If you won't accept change, you should try to make peace with it. Your bitterness has poisoned you.
I have no need of your pity.
I wasn't offering it. But if you step aside, you can keep your pride, since it's so important to you.
There'll be a reckoning.
You'll back away from it.
The Shadow Karja won't stop Ursa. They'll pick off the strongest of our number and the rest of us will scatter. I'd like an opportunity to share a drink with Erend. There's a man who knows how to enjoy life.
He gave them the best work he'd ever do. And look at it now.
They defaced it because they hated what it stood for.
They defaced a thing slaves like him lived and died for. Slaves they've already forgotten. Short-sighted bastards, the lot. If they thought their son set off this bridge, they'd jump after it. I thank you for honoring my wish.
I hope you can find peace.
I wouldn't know what to do with it, any more than the Karja do.
Good to see you. Life was never easy. And there's plenty of work here.
Life in the claim was never easy. Living here and die there.
The longer we stay here, the more it'll feel like. Stay busy, friend.
Here's to Avad, eh? He may dress a bit too fancy, but he's made a place in the Sundom for the Oseram.
The
I'd like an opportunity to share a drink with Aaron. There's a man who knows how to enjoy life. This pain spray. Charcoal smoked from a dozen forges. Work.
Here's what I don't get about the Sundom. All these fancy decorations everywhere. It's downright embarrassing.
I'll tell you what I like. The sound of hammer on steel. Is it just me, or do Karja people walk slow? They have places to be.
I miss Mainspring. Charcoal smoke, a dozen forges, milkweed work, decent liquor.
I keep the wheel turning all day. By the forge, I believe I've earned a drink or two. It's an honor to serve the Sun King. Steel to my soul. I miss the good.
The longer we stay here, the more it'll feel like home.
Wake to sleep. Bought my bed from a Karja. Just like them, it's soft. Here's to Avad, huh? He didn't dress a bit too fancy. But he's made a place in the Sundom for the awesome. But here's what I don't get about the Sundom. These fancy decorations.
It's a real turn.
It's a bit frivolous, isn't it? Imagine living anywhere else. I hope I never come across Redmore. It would crush me with the flick of its tail. Sun will. brought those rebels in Sunfall to a standstill. Why won't the Sun King finish it for good?
Hope everything's in order.
We all have our place in the order.
Don't let your guard down.
I have a matter of grace and beauty I would like to discuss with you.
What did you want to talk about?
Speaking of which, I wonder if you've come across a very special kind of flower. It's made of metal, like a machine. Other blossoms grow around them in amazing patterns. These gleaming beauties are very much in demand among my clients. If you bring me some, I have valuables to trade for them.
You said you were an adventurer.
Just so. The nobles of Meridian crave flowers for their balconies and gardens. So out I went, with bow and spear. I made my name by searching the wilds for the wildest blossoms. No bandit nor machine could keep me from those precious petals.
So what happened?
Love happened, my sweet. My paramour frets too much when I venture out. So now I collect flowers for those without such bonds.
Is it worth it? Being restrained like that?
Of course. Freedom is sweet. But the embrace of my beautiful Theridine sweeter still.
Thank you. These metal flowers, what are they exactly?
No one knows, but some say they began sprouting 20 years ago when the machine started to go mad. Perhaps they grow from the tears of the sun, for he has many faces, does he not? Wrathful one day, cool and patient the next? Perhaps he weeps for our suffering when his anger breaks. Ah, let us haggle over this beautiful bounty. I am always happy to trade with you. Till we meet again, my noble Nora. A moment of your time, Outlander?
But I fear it won't last much longer.
Could have sworn the other stall was down here.
Huh. You'll like what I have for sale. I promise.
Could you spare a moment to speak of the finer things?
Nice and bright.
Got all the best goods here. Fine goods for a fair price.
Let me tell you, a woman like you wouldn't care.
I've never broken bread with an outlander.
Check out these books now.
Ah, you're back.
Yes.
I look forward to trading with you again, my sweet. Everyone needs a splash of color in their lives. Come. Let's talk it over.
I've got all the best goods here.
You can do so much, Emeraldine.
Only the finest.
These aren't goods. They're necessities.
You're looking for artifacts.
Yes, but I'm no profiteer. Sun King Avad has named me an envoy to the Banuk. I work on their behalf, looking for sacred relics to return to their homeland, Ben-Ur. I'm especially interested in wooden figures that are sometimes found near Banuk rock paintings. If you have any, I have valuables to trade for them.
You said the king named you an envoy to the Banuk?
Yes. I've been to Ben-Ur many times, and the Wirak chiefs trust me. I help them maintain diplomatic ties with Avad. Some say they're a mysterious people, but their ways make a lot of sense to me. All you have to do is be the best. Doesn't matter if you're born high or low, man or woman. They respect skill, not some fool notion of heritage.
I see the appeal.
I wish more Karja did. Anything they don't understand, they call backward or savage.
Tell me more about these Banuk figures.
Simple wood sculptures, made by Arnak, a legendary hunter who was exiled from Ban-Ur for killing his chief. He left the figures near painted stones in places that reminded him of his homeland. Later, his tribe declared him innocent. Now they see him as a kind of wandering hero and want those figures back. I do what I can to help him get them, including trade for them, if you have any. You ready? Let's trade them. Come on back if you find any. I pay well for Banuk relics, Outlander.
These aren't goods. They're necessity. You'll like what I have for sale, I promise.
What brought about this twilight? Our son King must cleanse his father's sin.
Been all over the city and
fire. Goods for a fair price.
It won't cost you a shard just to look.
Don't pass up these goods.
Other soul is down here.
Killing people all over the sun.
You'll like what I have for sale.
I've got all the best goods here.
What you need. Won't cost you a
song. Back from the wilds. You ready? Let's trade. Come on back if you find any Banuk goods. I pay. Well, for Banuk relics, Outlander.
pass up these goods.
Don't forget to stock up before you're on the road. Come take a look. Give you a good price. Buy what you need, leave the rest. Check out these. Take a look at these wares.
That's Sun King of Bonds doing.
Able-bodied adventurers,
I'll
preferably with no friends or family, but I'm not choosing.
Huge. So you've come back to the temple.
I was invited back. The priests wanted to hear what I had to say about reconciliation with the other tribes. They're listening. At least they've begun to listen. There's a distance between ears and deeds.
Because of what we did?
What you did.
It was for the mourners. I think it helped them.
You set them on the path. You can't know what their journeys hold. Such is the priest's lot. Perhaps a red robe would suit you.
Not me. Besides, your temple doesn't even take women.
We would be richer if we did. Go in light, my friend, and let the sun cast your way.
Thank you, Naman. Where I'm going, I could probably use all the light I can get.
Our merchants are going to put my family out of business. Thank you.
share of a lucrative opportunity.
I know how to put them to use.
Come take a look. I'll give you a good price.
Let's have a chat. No, a colorful discussion.
It's always the ones you least expect to cause you trouble.
Time.
Times already.
Don't bother me, Outlander. I don't need a mercenary, I need a miracle. Someone who can tell me who slaughtered my men.
I'm a good tracker. Maybe I can help. What happened?
Mass murder, that's what. 5 night guards shredded like cabbage out there in the quarry.
Could machines have killed them?
Don't see how. The quarry is fenced and gated, and I've never seen a Glinthawk do anything like this.
Anything strike you as strange or out of the ordinary?
Well, let's see, Oh yeah, chunks of corpses, gushing blood. Sorry. Pressure's getting to me. Not used to murder. Nah, nothing unusual. Well, except we've been doing a little blasting lately, and Saravad said... No, that's just stupid.
5 men murdered? How?
Don't know. One was a buddy from before the liberation. We worked this quarry together as slaves for the Mad King. My friend, may he walk forever in the light, knew how to fight. Fiends who did this must have had stealth or numbers.
You've been using explosives?
Sure. To clear away bedrock and get to the good stuff, we do it for a week or so every year. But that's got nothing to do with the dead. They were... torn apart, not blown up.
What exactly did Saravad say?
Ah, nothing. Kept babbling about a pile of rocks out there. Said he didn't remember it from yesterday. I told him that this here is a quarry where we move rocks all day. So rocks getting moved ain't so surprising, lunkhead.
I'll have a look around the quarry.
If you think it'll help.
I've seen this 4 times already.
Sand in my throat. Burns. Explosives. Quarry's been doing a lot of blasting. Oh boy, you're a big one, aren't you?